Good morning, students. I hope you all are fine and doing good at home. Today, we will discuss a very interesting chapter of biology, nutrition in plants. It is chapter number 1 of your NCERT science book also. The contents of the chapter are introduction, mode of nutrition in plants, photosynthesis, other modes of nutrition in plant, how nutrients are replenished in the soil. You have already learnt in your previous class what is food, the substances which we eat to get energy. Why do we need food? To survive, to be alive. What are the functions of food? It gives us energy, it helps us to grow, it repairs our cells and tissues and etc. Then you have learnt components of food like carbohydrates, proteins, vitamins, minerals, fats, etc. in detail. Now let's discuss a new concept, nutrition. It is defined as the process by which living organisms take in and utilize food substances to obtain energy. It means how an organism is taking its food and consuming it. It is an act of providing the nutrients to the body cells of living organisms so that they can carry out different activities to keep themselves alive. Or in other way, we can say that it is a life process of providing the nutrients to the body so that it can perform some fundamental activities. Mode of nutrition in plant. Mode means the way how nutrition is taken, the act how nutrition is taken. And there are two modes of nutrition in plants, that is autotrophic nutrition and heterotrophic nutrition. Autotrophic nutrition and autotrophs. The mode of nutrition in which organisms make food themselves from simple substances and nourish themselves. Or we can say that the mode of nutrition in which organisms prepare their own food is called autotrophic nutrition. Green plants, all algae and some bacteria belong to this mode of nutrition, this category. Now, what are autotrophs? Auto means self and troph means nourishment. So, the organisms capable of preparing or synthesizing their own food are called autotrophs. Autotrophs are also called as producers because they produce the food. All the green plants are autotrophs. They prepare their own food by the process called photosynthesis. Heterotrophic nutrition and heterotrophs. The mode of nutrition in which living organisms take in ready-made food from different sources. These sources may be plants or animals. We can say that the mode of nutrition in which organisms do not prepare their own food but take the food from others. Non-green plants like fungi and all animals belong to this category. What are heterotrophs? Heteros means other and trophs means nourishment. So, the organisms who are not capable to synthesize their own food and obtain the food from other living organisms are called heterotrophs. Or we can say that the living organisms which are not able to make the food and intake the food from others are called heterotrophs. Since these organisms depend on other living organisms for their food, they are also called consumers because they consume the food prepared by others. As we have discussed, plants prepare their own food by photosynthesis. What is photosynthesis? Photosynthesis is food making process in plants from simple substances like carbon dioxide and water in the presence of sunlight. Oxygen is released during photosynthesis. Photo means light, synthesize means to combine. Since the synthesis of food occurs in the presence of sunlight, it is called as photosynthesis. It is a unique process on the earth. The solar energy is captured by the leaves and stored in the plants in the form of food. Requirement for photosynthesis, or what is needed for photosynthesis. Number 1, sunlight from sun. Number 2, chlorophyll present in the leaves. Number 3, carbon dioxide from atmosphere. Number 4, water from the soil. Let's discuss in details. Now we will discuss site or location of photosynthesis, that is chloroplast. Look at the figure carefully. It is a vertical section of a leaf where green colored dots are showing chlorophyll. Photosynthesis takes place in the green leaves of a plant. In the cells of the leaves, there are tiny structures, chloroplast, which contains green pigment called chlorophyll. This chlorophyll helps the plant to absorb the sunlight and then use it to synthesize or make the food. Chlorophyll absorbs solar energy and converts it into chemical energy. Food is made in the cells of the leaves, so leaves are also called as kitchen of the plant. So we can say that sun is ultimate source of energy for all the living organisms on the earth. Now we will discuss how the plants obtain carbon dioxide. Here is a figure on your screen which shows a leaf, b a section through a leaf, c stomata. There are a large number of tiny pores called stomata on the undersurface of the leaves of plant. Look at the figure B carefully, which shows the location of the stomata on the leaves. As you know, carbon dioxide is present in the atmosphere, but how it enters in the leaves? The carbon dioxide gas enters the leaves through the stomata, and oxygen, which is produced during the photosynthesis, is also released through stomata. This is the figure of stomata, which shows that stomata is minute opening surrounded by bean-shaped guard cells. The opening and closing of stomatal pores is controlled by guard cells. How the plants obtain water for photosynthesis? The water required by the plants for photosynthesis is absorbed by the roots of the plants from the soil. That you know very well. The water absorbed by the roots of the plants is transported upward to the leaves, where it reaches the photosynthetic cells. The plants also need other raw materials such as nitrogen, phosphorus, iron, magnesium, etc. for building their body. Nitrogen is used by the plants to make the proteins and other compounds. Although nitrogen is present in the atmosphere, yet plants cannot consume that nitrogen as it is. They need nitrogen in the dissolved form. The plants take these material from the soil. The photosynthesis takes place in the following steps. Number 1, water is absorbed by the roots from the soil. Number 2, carbon dioxide enters through stomata from atmosphere. Number 3, chlorophyll absorbs light or solar energy from the sun. Chlorophyll converts solar energy into chemical energy with the help of carbon dioxide and water. The food is prepared in the form of simple sugar called glucose. The extra glucose is changed into another food called starch, and this starch is stored in the leaves of the plant. In other way, we can say that
carbon dioxide and water get converted into simple sugar, glucose and oxygen by the chlorophyll in the presence of sunlight is called photosynthesis.
We can explain process of photosynthesis with the help of equation also. The two forms of equation are, number one, chemical equation, that is CO2 plus H2O in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll gives C6H12O6 plus O2. Number two, word equation, that is carbon dioxide plus water in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll gives glucose and oxygen. Now the question arises, why photosynthesis is important? Photosynthesis is important because, number one, it provides food to animals including human beings, so it is ultimate source of food and energy for all the living organisms. Number two, it puts life supporting gas oxygen into the air, which is essential for breathing and respiration in animals including human beings. Or in other way, we can say that during photosynthesis, oxygen is released, which is essential for survival of all the living organisms. Number three, it helps in maintaining the balance between oxygen and carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. Thank you, students. I hope you enjoyed the session. In the next lecture, I will continue the rest of the chapter. Till then, keep revising. Stay home, stay safe.